I don't want little black girls or little brown girls that look like me to look at the TV and see themselves in me and see themselves constantly being picked last.
Who would you rather have a one night stand with?
I'm not gagging because of Dirty Shirley. I'm gagging because of that dirty ass question you just asked me. I'm like, no, we're not a couple. We were a match. I have never, ever, ever, y'all getting this? Never has sex with this man. If you are in love with yourself, then you have the green light from the baddest bitch you know.
Meet Dirty Shirley, the iconic Shirley Temple you grew up with, grew up to. Think classic Shirley Temple, but with a twist. Dirty Shirley is packed with all the vibes. Cherry, grenadine, a splash of lemon lime, and get this. No red dye, no corn syrup, just real cherry juice and sugar. Dirty Shirley is the go-to drink of the summer. Get yours now at dirtyshirley.com and find it in over 20 stores across the U.S. Cheers to the dirtiest summer yet. Tolú,
baby.
Not Tutu or Tulum or what other names?
Tulum, Tofu. I'm like, I feel like y'all are trying to mispronounce it at this point. There's effort being put behind the mispronunciation.
Especially like with Chris, like, babe. Hi, we're a couple. Dating please. Someone that doesn't even know how to fucking say
that. No, we're not a couple. We were a match the show. That is official. Over, dead, done. It's not even an ex. People keep like referring to him as my ex. And I'm like, y'all, we were never, ever dating.
What's
ever.
The duration? Like, how long were you guys a match?
A match? We were a match for like 2 weeks.
Wait, okay. We have to get in to what happened.
Girl,
can we just get like a synopsis? I don't want you to relive the trauma and drama
of what happened after.
All we know, correct, unless I'm like missing my tea, is that you guys are no longer together.
We have 3 weeks of filming and they have to condense it into 10 episodes, right? So literally there are more things that happen that you don't see than you do see. After Xanthi came back during the big mixer and told me, you know, the tea of what was happening, I had actually went to production and I was like, y'all, I want to leave. I don't want to be here anymore. They're like, no, Tolú, you need to pick a match. And I was like, I don't want to match with any of these men. Y'all put me in a house with 11 men, zero of whom genuinely have interest or attraction in me. Yeah. Y'all got my black bald ass in here.
No, you know what? You know why they did that? They needed you. You were the personality hire.
Oh my God.
Gorgeous, by the way. So like if they don't see that, they're dumbasses.
And I say that, I believe now, like what Perfect Match has taught me is that my beauty, it seems to be for the female gaze because the people that have been speaking life into me and been pouring into me are the women and the gays. It's the girls and the girls.
The girls and the
gays. Yes, the girls and the girls. They have had my back. They have been my riders. Imagine being in a bubble for 4 weeks where you're constantly the last option, the not even the second choice. Like there was 11 of us, the 11th choice. And there's no escape for you. You have to continue. Like, because in the real world, if a dude treated me nasty and dirty, baby, I'm gone. I'm Casper the unfriendly ghost. After leaving that experience, I did have a moment where I started to doubt myself. I'm like, am I really beautiful? Because it's so easy for your ego and your self-confidence to kind of be to take a hit being in 4 weeks of an experience where you just constantly have men basically like laugh at you as the last option, if even that. I had to really take a moment to reevaluate, fall back in love with myself. I had to look in the mirror, say my affirmations, and be like, Tolú, you are beautiful, you are smart, you are funny, you are caring, you are kind. Mm-hmm. And just remind myself of all the things that make me. Yeah. And be like, if those idiots, because let's be real, I was in a house of himbos. But even want to swipe on any of these individuals?
Would you swipe right on anybody now knowing what you know?
Oh, girl.
I'm an intelligent girl.
Hell no. This brain says, that will never be the wave. Yeah. Oh, child, we went on a little tangent.
Back to the question. Well, welcome to fucking after curfew. God damn.
It was the dirty Shirley.
She had one sip of the dirty Shirley. Ooh, cheers.
You just eat it.
And she said, let's go off. What is life like now, though?
Oh, life now? Life now is great. It's amazing. You know what's really funny? Okay, so if you look at my Instagram bio, the first line on my Instagram bio is the main character, right? I did not put that because of the show. I've had that on my IG bio since I had 600 followers, before I ever even thought reality TV could be a thing. So now, it's so when I watched Perfect Match and I saw that they put my tagline as the main character energy.
Did they?
Yes!
Oh my God, I didn't even see that.
When I walk in, it says main character energy. I said, oh!
As it should!
I was looking at it and I was like, you know that bald bitch? I fuck with her. She's funny. Whenever her confessionals pop up, I'm like, oh, yes. What you got to say? Because I don't even remember half the things that I said. So I'm watching this, and I know the macro of what happens,
but the
little details, I'm like, damn, I said that? With the experience, I'm not going to lie. Part of it, I kind of just wanted to drown out of my memory. I think my brain was trying to protect me from some stuff, and she was like, you know what, girl, we're just gonna remember the great parts, the macros, and you don't need to focus on too many of the fine little details. Because after the big mixer, I told production, I was like, I want to leave. I don't want to be here anymore. I don't want to continue to be the last choice, the last option. I don't want little black girls that look like me or little brown girls that look like me to look at the TV and see themselves in me and see themselves constantly being picked last. It's like, I don't want to give that representation. If I deal with that in the real world, nobody is seeing that but me.
Yeah.
But on such a grand scale, like Netflix, I was like, I don't want that. And I had a really good producer talk to me, and she was like, Tolu, who are you? I was like, I'm Tolu. He's like, exactly.
Ooh.
It's like, exactly. You're Tolu. You are a one of one. Nobody can be Tolu but you. It's like, we have less than a week of this experience. Like, if you quit and leave now, and you can leave, but if you quit and leave now, what is that going to give the little girls that look like you? And I was like, you're so right. You're so right. So I got to keep fighting for my fucking life in this house.
I'm fighting for my life.
So at the end, I was like, okay, well, if I got to pick somebody, and the grand prize is a trip. It's not like we win any money. So I'm like, I would rather go on a trip with this, even though he's a fucking dumbass. Like, at least I know who he is. Mm-hmm. And the devil you know is better than the angel you don't kind of deal.
That's a good one.
Yeah. I was like, I know this devil. I know his ins and outs, and he's not the brightest bulb in the chandelier, but, there's a little flicker there that I can work with, I guess. Whereas if I start a brand new relationship from scratch, and I already know none of these men want me, child, I start a brand new relationship, and I got to start this whole ordeal from scratch, and then if we win, now I got to go on a trip with a stranger.
Mm.
I don't want to do that. So I was like, okay, you're right. I'm going to stay with this fool. And I did. Then after we were done filming, and mind you, I want everybody to know that I would ask him frequently off camera, because I feel like people are real and authentic when they don't feel like they have to put on a show. So I would ask him off camera, dude, what is this? What are you doing? What are we doing? What's going on? I said, you had one opportunity where I wasn't in your face and you went around and you tried to fuck around. So what exactly are you doing?
Right.
And he was like, no, I made such a mistake, blah, blah, blah. I was just trying to, what did he say? I was just trying to take advantage of the experience. The whole purpose of this is to date around. I was like, no, the whole purpose of this is to find your perfect match.
When you go, when you go out, you know what you're attracted to, you know mm-hmm. what you're vibing towards. Mm-hmm. You go look through 20 men, you'd be like, okay, I'm intrigued by him. Why the fuck are we tasting
all
the different flavors and all the different vibes?
If you know you're a tequila girly, why the fuck would you go and get vodka and gin and whiskey? And if you're a tequila, baby, stay with
you. You're going to throw up. Thank you. You're going to be in the fucking toilet.
Thank you. Yeah. So I asked him repeatedly. I've asked this man no less than 10 times. No less than 10 times. Also, I want the record to, I need to put this on the record. I corrected this fool on my name a million billion times, right? So anyway, I asked him, what are you doing? What exactly are you playing? Are you playing a game? Are you playing a role? Let me know so I can also, at least I know. And he was like, no, I know I fucked up with Xanthi, but, I really, really, really do like you. I can't act this good. I really do like you. And I was like, you're not really a good actor. It's not giving that you do.
Like giving Oscar performance.
It's not giving Oscar worthy. He's like, and like he cried, like off camera. He was like, no, I know I really fucked up. I really like you, Tolu. I really do. So I was like, okay. Look, we have less than a week of this experience. I'm already with this dude. So like I'll just continue to allow myself to be enthralled in the experience. Like mm-hmm. I'll allow myself to show up. Like I've already been wearing my heart on my sleeve. What do I look like climbing back up? You know?
Yeah.
After we were done, you know, we didn't win. You know, we were in the hotel because we had to do like promos. Mm-hmm. And so we were in the resort for three days. And then, you know, in the resort, we would spend some time together. And like he himself would talk about like life after. Like he would tell me like, no, I really fucked up with that whole staying in contact thing, blah, 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 blah. I was like, yeah, that was really stupid. He's like, but you know, I'm not good with words. I was like, yeah, you're not good at a lot of things. But like, so he would be like, yeah, no, I really do want us to give it a shot. Like I remember one time we were in the hotel and he was, he was drunk. He was crying and he was like, I just feel like I'm 30 or I'm about to be 30. I don't know what I'm doing with my life. I don't know, but I do know that I really like you. And I was like, and me, I'm a sucker for tears. Like I'm a sucker for tears. Mm-hmm. I won't lie. And I always believe that, you know, a drunk man don't tell no tales. So I was like, okay, he's drunk. He's being vulnerable. Like I will accept him for that.
Okay.
So after we wrapped, right, he wanted to keep in contact. So I was like, okay, we could keep in contact. So I would text him because we keep in contact, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So like he would text me. He's like, text me when you make it back to Houston. I would text him. We texted for a little bit. And then I remember I would text him and he took 4 days to respond to me.
Delivered for like more than 4 minutes. I'm having a mentee.
And then I started calling my girl. I called Xanthi because that's my girl. I called Xanthi. I said, this fool is taken. It's been 2 hours. I said, ooh. She's like, don't worry. I was like, okay. It's been a day. She's like, don't worry. I said, bitch, it's been two. She said, don't worry. I said, bitch, it's been three. She's like, okay. And after the fourth day, I said, all right, cool. So I sent him a text message. And mind you, literally, like, I sent him a text message. I said, so it's true, you're a piece of shit. Yeah, in the message. And I said, oh, it's true, you're a piece of shit. I hope it was all worth it. You were playing games for the cameras. I was like, have a great life. I hope it was all worth it. That's how I ended it. Mm-hmm. And he sends me this long ass text message. I read it. I didn't respond. Then he's like something. He sends me another message. I didn't respond. I didn't have an option in the house. Now we're outside. There's 8 billion people in this world. You think I'm going to sit here and play these games with you, settle for you, be your consolation prize? Maybe you're not the prize. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Like let's be real. You're not the prize. Right. And I'm not going to sit here and wait for you. So he would text me. I didn't respond. I was like, cool. I'm pulling you on you, but I'm gonna do it times 10.
Was that how it was left?
Yeah, that was how it was left. Then he would text me some more. And then I remember he was like, happy. The last time we texted each other was in September because the show wrapped in August.
Nothing like is that serious where you need to wait 4 days nothing. Unless you are dead, deceased in a casket, mm-hmm. babe.
And even then, here. I'm still like. Okay.
Check a pulse.
I was like,
unless okay. You are casket fucking ready.
Mm. That was the last time we had communication. And then I saw him at a party when I moved down to LA. I saw him at a mutual friend's birthday party. Ooh. And oh girl, clock this tea. This fool is gonna come up to me. He's like, oh, hey, Tolu. It's like, it's Tolu.
If he
girl
be fucking girl. For real.
I said, it's Tolu. He's like, oh, hey, Tolu. And I was like, hello. And I said, hello, Christopher. And then
like, I love the full names. You know it's serious. When you're in trouble, full fucking names.
Word for word, bar for bar, I said, hello, Christopher. He's like, oh, you're saying hi, so you don't hate me anymore. I was like, hey, I'm being cordial. I'm a lady. I don't have to scream I don't like you, but I don't have to scream my head off at you mm-hmm. like in public. I'm just being cordial. Mm-hmm. He's like, oh, so the show's almost coming out. How do you feel? And I was like, it's cool. And he's like, so how do you want to play this? And I said, what do you mean by that, Christopher? And he goes, have a storyline. How do you want to play this? I was like, play what?
Yeah, what?
I was like, are you insinuating that I should sit here and pretend like we're still like we're together? Me? Together with you? This is not a script. This is not a role. I am not an actress. I am not going to act any fucking role with you. Yeah. We're not playing shit.
All right. So now that perfect match is over.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Been over for a minute, mm-hmm. but recently over for us. Are you dating? Are you on the apps? Like, what is your story now?
I'm actually not on any apps.
Really?
Yeah, no, the apps scare me.
Have you ever been on the apps before?
I have. Like, before I became, like, a public figure on reality TV, I was on the apps. But, like, even on them, I'm a scary little bitch because I'm, like, I feel like my personality is best consumed in person. Mm. I don't know how to, like, text and be as vibrant via, like, a message or a DM or a, you know, like, I love a phone call or a FaceTime.
Over, like, a text?
Hell yeah.
What are your top three things that you're looking for?
He's got to be tall. Because I love to wear heels. I know y'all saw me with Chris. But, again, it was slim pickings.
Is he a shorty? He is a shorty.
He's not tall.
He's giving, like, Lord Farquaad.
He's, you know what's crazy? That's what Harry called him. Shut in the up. House. Harry would literally call to him Lord Farquaad. Yeah, Harry don't got no filter. Yeah, he would call him Lord Farquaad in the house. And I would, you know, I'd be defending, hey, Harry, that's mean.
That's my man, but, like,
I see it. I get it. I love dark features. Mm. So, like black hair or, like, dark eyes. Like, I love dark features and good teeth. Mm. I had adult braces. Okay. I got braces when I was 22.
Shut up. Did you get Invisalign or, like, the
braces, girl. My first corporate job out of college, I had braces in my mouth. I was the youngest. I was the only black person. And I had braces. I was like, oh, Lord. It's getting different.
Oh, my God.
So you have to have nice teeth because I'm like, I went through the stress to make my teeth look presentable.
I put in my hours.
I did my time. And now I, like, look at teeth because I'm just like, I know the stress that I went through. So I, like, I look at it. So, and be handsome. But I feel like, of course, like, duh, be handsome. That goes without saying. Personality. Number one personality trait that I'm looking for. I want a man that is caring. There's a difference between being kind and being caring. Caring is leading with your action. The macros, like, of course the big things, duh, but, like, the smaller things, that's the daily stuff. That's the consistency, precisely. Yeah. It's not like, oh, it's her birthday. Oh, it's Valentine's Day. Let me do something. It's like, oh, you know what? I'm at the store and I know that this is her favorite chocolate bar. And I know it just put a little smile on her face if I come home and just like, babe, I thought of you. Here you go.
When I used to date, I was like always looking for macro.
Mm-hmm.
And then I like really had like a wake up call. Like I had a really bad experience and I'm like, I need to start looking for somebody that's just consistent in the day to day.
Heavy.
Makes me coffee in the morning. Mm-hmm. Like we'll be there to fucking tuck you in or like breakfast. Give you the goodnight kiss. It's not always about like going on the yacht or like doing these like luxurious
and it's
things.
So easy to be love bombed by someone who constantly just does macro or not constantly but like puts in that short-term effort to do the macro things.
Yeah,
like that's how you get love bombed. Like oh my God, he's buying me stuff, he's doing this, he's doing that. Eventually that's gonna wear off and he's gonna stop.
Yeah.
But those little micro efforts, like that's a personality trait at that point.
Right.
You know, and you know that that's going to withstand the test of time and he's going to continue to put in that energy and that effort into you.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't get love bombed because it's just how he shows love. Now, I used to think I needed a man that could match my energy, but I recognize that I have so much. If I could just find a man that that falls in love with my energy and mm-hmm. doesn't feel like he needs me to mellow out or dim me down. Like he recognizes my light and it's not overbearing. It's not too bright for him.
Yeah.
And he's just supportive. Like, you know what, my girl, she gonna dance in the middle of the street because she just gonna dance in the middle of the street. And then last but not least, you have to be communicative because I just love a man that is an effective communicator because I'm an effective communicator.
Yeah. Yes. I feel like even through the show, like you were tested so many times where mm-hmm. like most people would snap.
Let's be real. Nobody's like all rainbows and fucking roses all day every day. Like mm-hmm. you're gonna have exactly yeah. it's not sustainable. You're gonna have moments of conflict, but the deciding factor is how do you guys react in those moments of conflict? How do you resolve those moments of conflict? Mm-hmm. How is conflict resolution? You know, if you rich, that's just icing on the cake. I always say this. I said generational wealth did not come from generational wealth, but generational wealth will come from me.
Do you feel like you are looking prior to the show?
Because
mm-hmm. I feel like you went through like a whirlwind of like a dating experience.
Oh, child.
Like before, after, do you feel like you're looking for the same types of things?
When I did the show.
Yeah.
This was before the trust had even come out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I filmed Perfect Match like 5 months after I filmed the trust. So mm-hmm. I was not a public figure. Like I walked into this room of people that I've watched on TV. I walked in very just like, I don't know what to expect, but I'm going to keep myself open to the experience. Let me do something different from what I would normally do on the outside. Mm-hmm. Let me look for something different than I would normally.
Yeah, that's such a good way to do it though, because we do have types.
Yes.
And going against your type is sometimes the best thing that you can do. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I just wanted to allow myself to be open. Like, you know, I just wanted to allow myself to be open, because I even said it on the show. I was like, Chris is not the kind of guy that I would ever go for on the outside. But in this experience, I'm allowing myself to be open to new and different things.
Right.
Did I like the new and different things that I had? No. But at least I tried it, and yeah. I know, you know. But now on the outside, again, we are in a world of 8 billion people to choose from. There are certain just like non-negotiables that I'm looking for now, especially mm-hmm. with what I went through in the house. Like, I can never be with a man. Like, that's why I said I need to be with a man that I feel like does not ever try to dim my light or like mellow me out. Because my experience with a lot of my matches and my partners, like, especially being with one of them.
Uh-huh.
It was.
Exactly. Say the names.
Like, when I was matched with Dom.
I knew. Like, just say it, girl. Come on.
I constantly felt like, I think I'm too much. I need to be less. I hated being in that space where I was questioning myself, because like my personality is, it's core to who I am, right? Yeah. So I hated being in that space where I was like, maybe I'm just a little too much. I'm a little too eccentric. Maybe I'm too loud. And I hated that.
Mm-hmm.
And now I recognize, like, I will never, ever, ever, ever allow myself to put myself in a position to be with a man that makes me feel as though I am too much. And I don't regret, like, honestly, I don't regret anything that happened in the show, because I feel like I walked away with so many lessons. And I walked away with a lot more clarity as to who I am. Yeah. And who I want to give the privilege of being in my space and in my face.
Yeah.
And mm-hmm. So I learned a lot about who I am and what I will stand for while being on Perfect Match.
Yeah.
You either win or learn.
Yeah.
There's no losing.
Win or learn.
Win or learn.
I love it. What would you say the biggest misconception is about you, like on the show or like another cast member?
They cut out a lot of the scenes where I questioned many of my matches on their intention.
Mm.
And it did not show when, like, so for example, I feel like they made me look like a freaking puppy dog at Dom and Chris's
feet. Oh my God, I was gonna say that.
They literally made me look like a puppy.
You look like you're waiting around all night. Like,
bruh.
Are you gonna pick me? Or like,
bruh. Bruh.
It was giving desperado. And I'm like, that's not my girl.
That's not me at all. And yeah. Even like, I literally, there were so many times I was like, bro, I'm ready to go. My bags is packed. Like, I'm gonna just go to the resort. I'm gonna eat my food.
You're
I'm gonna
watch Tulum, some. Babe.
No, bruh. Yeah. I was like, I'm ready to go. But literally, they did not show so many scenes where these men, these boys would come to me and be like, no, totally, you're right. I'm so sorry. I really like you. I'm genuinely interested in you. I want to continue to pursue this connection. They cut all that out. So I'm just looking like I'm waiting around like, oh, please pick me him. No, the hell it wasn't. And then there were so many times I got into fights with these gentlemen because I'm like, you're being fugazi. You're not being authentic. I do not believe you. And then they would cut all of that out of me questioning them mm-hmm. and me being like, I question your authenticity. And I don't believe the shit that you're saying. And then later on, they'll be like, no, I'm so sorry. I'm for real. And I'm a forgiving person. So I'll be like, okay.
What's your sign?
I'm a Capricorn.
Aww.
Yeah.
Love it.
I'm a December Cap. No, it's Earth.
Earth.
I'm grounded AF. I did have a little nip slip moment, but it's cute because
I mean, like, the side boobs are side boobing.
The side boobs are boobing, honey.
Honestly, I prefer a side boob over cleavage.
Over cleavage.
This is something about underboob too. I feel like there's so much underboob.
Underboob is so
this
sexy.
Season.
Underboob is so sexy.
It is. There's something about it.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's like you could see, but you can't see it all. Babe.
I've been wanting to get more underboob, but you know, sometimes my girls, she has a mind of her own.
Mm.
This is Desiree.
Shut
this
up.
This is Destiny.
Hello, ladies. Yeah. Welcome to Upper Curfew.
And Desiree, she's really that girl who just like do what she want to do. But Destiny too also be having her moments.
Yo, your tits the same size.
No, Desiree is bigger than Destiny.
Okay, yeah, sisters, not twins.
No, exactly.
And she's got a little like more, she's thicker.
Mm-hmm.
She's a little more thick.
And she's then got this like one, a little birthmark on her.
Oh, yeah. I know. I have a big freckle on mine too.
That's how you know you're a bad
I got
bitch.
A name on.
Yeah, girl. Give them what should a we name. Ooh, what's your alter ego?
My friends call me Mill, which I'm like, I don't even understand what the fuck that means. It's like Mill? Because I'm Jill.
Oh.
And so they call me Mill when I act up.
Like giving Millie Barbie Brown type
of. Ooh, Millie. Give me like a good Southern name. Mm. I want Southern Belle. Sweet tea. She's giving biscuits. She's giving barbecue.
Like, is Christy? No.
Christy's too basic. Yeah, I'm not sorry Christy. For all the Christies out there.
Oh, all the Christies just unfollowed you.
Whatever. I don't care. I want to say, and I don't know where this name came from, Jalissa.
Millie and Lissa eat.
Yes.
Eat.
Desiree and.
Destiny.
Destiny. Enough about our tits, even though they are absolutely fabulous.
Never enough.
We're going to play. Well, we'll put them on pause for now.
Put it on pause.
Dirty Shirley.
Okay.
Sip or spill.
Sip or spill.
All right. So you can either sip on your Dirty Shirley, mm-hmm. which is absolutely fabulous.
It if actually
you haven't
is
had
really
one.
Good.
Yes.
Okay, before we start, I just want to get my sips in.
Get the palate wet. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you can sip or you can spill the tea.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. First question. Fuck, marry, kill.
Okay.
Cast members.
Fuck, Kaz. Marry, Justin. Kill, Chris.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Who would you rather have a one-night stand with? Harry Jowsey. Is that how you say his last name?
Yeah, Jowsey.
Harry Jowsey. Or Dom Gabriel. She said, hard
oh,
fucking
hell nah.
Pass.
I'm not gagging because of Dirty Shirley. I'm gagging because of that dirty ass question you just asked me.
No, fucking dead. Okay, which cast member would you want to see naked?
Okay, Kaz, because he's just the finest one there. Let's be so fucking for real. Kaz is so fine. Amongst the girl, Alara, she's so fine.
Mm-hmm. She was like the baddie of the,
bruh.
I mean, I think you're the baddie of the season.
Okay, thank
but
you.
But I feel like the male gaze.
Baddie, yes.
Was all about.
For sure.
All about her.
If I was a male, I would gaze upon her as well.
Do you think, which I guess this kind of was confirmed, Harry and Melinda, did they really kiss?
Like, oh, without a shadow of a doubt. I know that they kissed before we even saw the footage.
We saw the ASMR. We mm-hmm. didn't see the proper footage. So it's like they could have, I don't know.
No, they kissed, girl.
Okay.
No, they kissed, girl. Because one thing about I will say about Melinda, she can be eccentric, but she is not going to lie on her name like that. There's literally no benefit. There's all risk, no reward.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, no, they definitely kissed without a shadow of a doubt. As soon as she said it, I was like, yeah, Harry did that shit.
Okay. All right. If you could choose a partner or partners for a threesome from the cast, who would you pick? I mean, you could drink, but I really want you to spill.
Oh my gosh. Who would I pick for a three? Ew. First off, okay. Before I answer this question, I need the world to know I do not do threesomes. I don't think I never could. I never have. I don't think I ever could in my life. No, it would be my two super freaks that I want to see naked. It would be Kaz and Alara.
Okay.
Oh, wait. No, because I feel like Justin would be a sweetheart though. I feel like he'd be such a sweetheart. I want to be the unicorn in this experience. So
if it's not all about me, I'm not fucking doing
like
it.
I'm not with it.
Yeah.
I think it would be Justin and Dominique. Yeah. Just because Dominique, she's for the girls. So mm-hmm. like I would be the main focus.
Yeah.
And then Justin seems like such a sweetheart, lover boy. So I would be the main focus. So attention will be on me.
Who from the Perfect Match cast do you think would be the worst in bed?
I say Chris because first off, let's set the record straight. I have never, ever, y'all getting this? Never. has sex with this man. We ain't did nothing more than kiss, child. I ain't even seen his peen. People been asking me, they're like, is Chris really uncut? I don't know.
Wait. You didn't do a cheeky grab, a little gaze, like...
I saw him a little bit when he was taking a shower, but, like, I wasn't looking for his penis. So I'm very respectful. So, like, and, like, keep in mind, remember, I said my body count on this show. Like, I've had sex with less than 5 men.
Yeah.
In this world.
Yes.
So I'm just very, like.
And his body count was fucking outrageous.
Ridiculous.
50 to 100.
It's ridiculous.
Babe, do you have a job?
How do you That's have a full-time the time? Job. He doesn't have a job, I don't think. But how do you have the time? How do you have the time? And then so I say that because he's so hypersexual. And then he makes these podcasts, like how we're just talking girl talk.
Having fun.
He makes these podcasts where he was like, oh, this specifically is when I knew. I was like, I don't think this man could fuck at all.
Yeah.
Bruh, he was in this podcast with Peter from Too Hot to Handle. And he was talking about like, they were like, how do you make a girl come? First off, as a woman, let me ask you, how do you make a girl come?
The clit.
Thank you. Ooh, I love talking to girls because girls have sense, right?
Yes.
This dude said, he was like, oh, easy. You put a pillow under their back while they're laying down. And then like when you go in them, you go under, then you go up, then you go from side to side. I said, what the fuck is this dude saying?
Fucking lifesaver? He said,
I call it the corkscrew. I said, what the fuck? Oh, I know this man can't fuck. I just know it. I know you've never made a girl come in your life.
Hell to the fucking no. Because
what the fuck is the corkscrew? Literally, all you do is where it needs to be, and I promise you she will be on cloud 9.
Get
what
a vibe?
The fuck is a,
bruh. The vibrator?
Bruh.
That's all I need.
The bullets? She gonna do it.
She said,
period. She gonna do it. She's so that's what I say. Because well. I'm like, I don't think that man could actually... well at all.
It's so funny. I feel like the people who talk about sex the most are the ones that are the most unexperienced. Everyone should know clit simulation.
Thank you. And if you don't know, how about you ask a woman?
I know. Isn't that so funny? Like guys are always like, oh, I know. It's like, no, yeah. It's on my body. Like, I think I know.
Like if it's how do you make a woman come? Me as a woman, I feel like I would be an expert in the matter.
Right.
But that.
You set the record straight.
Yes.
I was so curious. I'm like, are y'all just fucking everyone?
Girl, never fuck that man.
Moving on from that.
Moving on.
Who do you think was faking their personality the most for the cameras?
Steven.
Really?
Steven. I love Alara. That is my girl. Uh-huh. I love her. After the show was done, and mind you, Steven tried to paint himself on the show as like, you know, I'm so serious, I'm a lover boy, I really like you. Mm-hmm. Like I thought that they were so madly in love.
Same.
And so why a week after filming did you ghost my girl?
Did he properly ghost her?
He properly ghosted her.
How the fuck do you go on a show mm-hmm. on Netflix, mm-hmm. everyone sees it, mm-hmm. and then just not respond to that person mm-hmm. back? Mm-hmm. What?
And then after like, I think it was like after a few days or a week or something, he sends her this long ass text message about how, oh, he's busy, he's working on things, he doesn't have time for a relationship, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, then why the fuck were you love bombing on the show, planning out all these dates, telling her how much you love her, how much you like her, like how y'all should start looking for apartments together in either London or in LA, like y'all are about to move in together. That's so disgusting to me.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, these are real people with real feelings that you're playing with.
Right.
Like to you, this is a show, this is a film, you're playing a role.
Yeah.
But if you're playing a role, then let the other party know that
right.
this is a role.
Right.
You have real feelings involved.
Yeah.
Ugh.
And you feel like her feelings were real for him.
Her feelings were so real for him.
Ugh, that's awful.
They were so real for him. And like I feel like that for all the women. Like we all had genuine mm-hmm. feelings, we all had genuine feelings and we just showed up with our heart on our sleeves. And
yeah.
those men, sorry, that's a mistake. Those boys just played with that. And it's disgusting.
Yeah.
But
who from the cast do you trust the least around a significant other?
No, I think all the girls were good for the most part. There's There's one that I think in my head, but I'm just not going to say that out loud.
She said, ooh.
No, actually, no, there is one that I think in my head, but I'm just.
Oh, I want to know.
Just sip on this tea, child.
Ugh. Who do you think is the most overrated cast member in terms of looks?
I would say Harry, because he uses his pretty privilege to get away and say whatever the fuck he wants. Mm-hmm, because mm-hmm. he knows that he is a conventionally attractive man. He's tall. He has an accent. So he has pretty privilege. That's why he can walk around TV, talk about who he skeeted in, talk about Ooh. Who gets cream pie.
Oh, my God. All the audacity.
Girl.
If somebody ever fucking said that they cream pied in me on national television, bitch.
Girl.
I'd be shocked.
When I watched that scene, I was like, no. You're fucking lying.
Yeah.
You're fucking lying.
Right. The last question.
Oh, sad.
Who was the most manipulative person in the show?
All the boys. It's Harry. It's Steven. It's Chris. Yeah, those three. No, I can't even say Kaz was manipulative because at least he did the shit with his chest, you know? Like, he showed you who he was. It's up to you whether or not you want to accept that. Easy peasy.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. So you briefly mentioned in the past, like, which is fucked up and traumatizing.
I already know.
You're like, bitch, I know. Let's get into
question.
It.
Let's get it.
Which was like, it was kind of brushed on. And like, I just want to like hear what actually went down. The cheating. Mm. You're with a guy for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
His wife called you on Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Hi, happy holidays.
So I was a freshman in college. Uh-huh. He was a grad student. Right? So we had an 8-year age gap. Yeah,
those
girl.
Older men, you yeah, think they're going to be girl. Good?
I was young and dumb, and I just wanted to be in love and be loved. It was my first boyfriend. He was my first, like, ever in life.
Everything, yeah.
My first everything. And we dated for 2 years, right? And, like, things were going great. He was an international student. Things were going really great, like, thought we were gonna get married. He was the one. I was like, oh, one and done. Okay, Tolu, get it, girl.
Get it.
And like, you know, he was talking about it too. Like, yeah, I can't wait. We're gonna get married. Blah 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 blah. I was like, okay, awesome. Like, I'm not ready yet, but like, I'll be ready. At this point, he had graduated, right? Because grad school is 2 years.
Okay.
He had graduated grad school, and like, we were still together, still madly in love. And I remember he would come up to me. He would constantly, like, because he was an international student, so he didn't have, like, his papers yet.
Yeah.
So he would constantly, like, bring that up. Like, hey, you know, we need to get married soon so that I can get my papers. And I'm like, okay, well, I'm still a junior in college. I need to graduate college, get my degree, and then we can talk about marriage. Because he still had time. Right.
You're still had time. So young, too.
I'm still so young, right?
Yeah.
And he was like, okay, but we need to get married. I'm like, okay, well, we will, but you need to wait. So then I remember Thanksgiving, like the weekend of Thanksgiving, I was going to drive home to Houston because I went to school in San Antonio.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to drive home to Houston to go spend it with my family because this was the first year that my parents usually work every Thanksgiving. But for some reason, on some fluke, they were both off this year. So I spent the night with him. You know, we did things that couples do. We were so madly in love. Mwah. Woke up the next morning, drove home. He was like, hey, babe, make sure you text me or call me when you get home. I was like, okay, baby, no problem. So I drove home. Then when I got there, I was texting him. I was like, hey, babe, I'm home. He didn't respond. I was like, okay, no problem. I'm with my parents. You know, we a kiki, having fun. Mm-hmm. And then I would text him again, no response. I was like, okay, that's kind of weird because he's usually quick to respond to me. Mm-hmm. So I called him. I'm like, hey, baby, like, I'm here. I called and he didn't pick up. And I was like, okay, it's kind of weird, but whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Then I remember being in my room and I'm just like chilling. I'm just in my room chilling. And then I got a call from him. So I'm like, okay, because it says baby or bae. I think that was his name.
Yeah.
Right. So I pick up. I'm like, okay, bae's calling. I pick up. I'm like, hey, baby, I'm here. I made it on time. And then there's a woman on the other line. And I'm looking at the phone. The phone definitely say bae. And I go, who is this? And then she goes, well, I want to know who's been calling my husband. And I'm looking at the phone, and it still says bae. And I'm like, who the fuck is your husband? My boyfriend of 2.5 years, mind you, 2.5 years. And mind you, this dude, when he literally, like, he was, you know, struggling, starving college students. Mm-hmm. He was a struggling, starving college student. Like, so I'm Mrs. Hold You Down. So I'm like, it's okay, babe. Like, just come move into my dorm with me and my 3 roommates. Just move into my small little shoebox of a dorm room. And he lived with me for 1.5 years. Yeah. So, and then
rent free. Bitch.
I remember we got into a big fight because I asked him, I was like, can you please help me pay half of rent? And he was like, how do you expect me to pay for rent? I'm paying all this in tuition. I remember he paid me for rent like twice. But I was just, you know, I was young. It's my first boyfriend. I know. I'm like,
the things that we will do in our early 20s for fucking men could be a whole podcast episode.
I promise you a bit. And I wasn't even in my 20s yet.
Yeah. And how old was he?
He was 8 years older.
Oh, I'm not good at math, but girl, the math is not good.
The math is not mathing. Period. So anyway, she's like, I want to know who's been calling my husband. I was like, your husband, this has been my boyfriend of 2 years. She's like, we got married, I think it was like 6 months ago or 4 months ago. I was like, what the fuck are you talking about? I was like, who the fuck are you? What is your name? What are you talking about? And then she's like, I'm just telling you now, let this be the last time that you call my husband or you text him. And then she hangs up. And then I'm just like, what the fuck is going on? Yeah. So I call my mom, because what else am I going to do? I call mom. Yeah. And I'm crying. I'm like, mommy, Chinedu called me and it was a woman on the phone and she said she's his wife. He's married. I'm like sobbing. Brown or cry just thinking about it. I'm like sobbing because this is like the love of my life, I thought.
Yeah.
And she's like, what are you talking about? What are you saying? You're lying. I was like, no, really. And then he calls again. Right when I'm with my mom, he calls again. It says bae. So I pick up. I was like, he's calling. I pick up. It was a butt dial. I hear arguing in the background. She's like, you're a fucking liar. You're a fucking liar. You said you're not talking to her anymore. You're a fucking liar. And then he goes, babe, no, I don't know why she's calling me.
Oh, my God. Bruh.
And I'm listening to all this. I'm like, what the? Like, I'm literally, the phone is on mute. I'm sobbing. My mom's like, shh, shh, shh.
Like, your girl's like, shut up, bitch.
Girl, it's tea. We gotta get the tea.
Fuck me.
And then, like, they're arguing. I'm listening to them argue the entire time. She's, you're a fucking liar. I knew you weren't trustworthy. Da, 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 da. And then I hear beep, beep, beep. And then, like, it hangs up. So I call his best friend. I call Chinadu's best friend. And I'm like, yo, what the fuck just happened? Why did I get a call from Chinadu's wife? What mm-hmm. the fuck just happened? And he's like, oh, Tolu, so you found out.
Oh, bitch. The way I would freak. I would freak the fuck out. I said,
and mind you, this is my friend too. Like, this is my friend. And I'm just like, so you knew.
Oh. No.
He's like, yeah, but I've been telling him to tell you. He said he was gonna tell you. I don't want to be the one to tell. I was like, so you knew, and you let me continue to give myself to this man, every aspect of myself to this man, and you knew. Bet. Hang up on him. Block Chinadu's number. Block him on also. No, I sent him this long ass text message basically saying, fuck you, burn in hell, all that shit.
Yeah.
Blocked him on everything. Blocked his number, everything, right? So then, like, a week later, I get this random text from this number that I don't even fucking know. And apparently, he has his friend, he recruited one of his friends because I blocked him.
Yeah.
To now text me, basically to try to apologize. Like, hey, you know what you're gonna do? He's really missing you. He's not okay. He's not himself. He hasn't been eating. I said, then he should die. Good. He should starve and die. If he doesn't want to eat, no, I should feel bad. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Like, he's like, oh, you know, he just did what he had to do. He really misses you, blah, blah, blah. I was like, nah, fuck that, no. Dude. Fuck you for coming up. I don't even know you, dude. Yeah. Fuck you for coming on my phone telling me to take back this dirty piece of shit. And all of you, I hope you have enjoy your time in hell, because that's where you're going. You're all going to hell.
Yeah.
Enjoy your time. So yeah, I blocked him. He recruited a couple other people to beg on his behalf. Mm-mm. Control all deleted like, that with fool.
Being on the shows and everything, did he ever try to like come back?
No, I'm not gonna lie. That like just turned me off of men for mm-hmm. a while until I met like my next boyfriend. He reinstated my trust in men somewhat. Like he made me feel like, okay, you know what? There are shitty people out there, but every now and then you find some real genuine, authentic men. Mm-hmm. And my last ex, Miguel, he is that. He is a real, genuine, authentic man. Aww. And damn, I kind of miss him, but we vibe.
Hey, Miguel, call me.
Love you.
Oh, no. Yeah, it really does take like one guy to be like, okay, they're not all bad.
Like, they're not all pieces of shit. Most of them are.
99.99%.
Yeah. But that 0.001, mm-hmm. they can reinstate your faith in humanity somewhat.
Has it been shaken since like this whole recent experience?
Feel like it's been reinstated. Like, yeah. I already knew that men ain't shit.
Yeah.
But like, this experience, like, yeah, no, men ain't shit. You know, no, let me not say that. Boys ain't shit. But there are genuine, real men out there. And when he's ready, come and find me, baby. I'm tired of being on the streets. Like, the streets are cold, nasty, and gross.
But, I mean, you're thriving now.
Oh, thriving. Like, for sure.
Understatement is thriving.
Now,
yeah.
Tolu. Yeah.
Tolu, not Tulum.
Not Tolu. Not Tulum. Not Tofu.
Tofu.
And fuck all of y'all that called me Tofu. Like, come on now. Let's be so fucking for real. Let's be so fucking for real.
Well, Miss Tolu, we're going to wrap it up there, even though I'm so pissed because I want to keep talking to you. But what is one piece of advice that you would give to people?
I would say never be afraid to just be authentically yourself. And don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that everybody's gonna love you, because that's never the case. If everybody loves you, then I feel like you're doing something wrong and you're not being authentically yourself. Be polarizing a little bit, but be authentically yourself, because the people that love and appreciate you for you, that's when you're gonna find your people. And those people, they are gonna be the ones to pour into you on the days that you feel empty. So never be afraid to just be you. Don't feel like you have to be palatable. Don't feel like you have to be everybody's cup of tea, because I said this on my TikTok. I was like, those with a palate refined enough to truly appreciate the tea that is you, they're the ones that are going to be in for a treat. And stand in your confidence. People always ask me like, Tolu, how are you so confident? Honestly, I didn't know that I was confident until everybody started saying that. Like, I just stand authentically in who I am. I'm like, you know what? I'm Tolu. Yes, I can be loud sometimes. I can be eccentric. I am high energy. I am fashionable as fuck. But that is me. And I am in love with all those aspects of myself. Fall in love with yourself, and then others will fall in love with you. And even if they don't, baby, the baddest bitch in the world is in love with you. Mm-hmm. You, if you are in love with yourself, then you have the green light from the baddest bitch you know.
Yeah.
You. And that's on period.
I love it. Well, thank you so much for being at After Curfew.
Thank you for having me.
Absolute blast.
This is fun girl chat.
Girl, you gotta come back.
No, girl, call me. Let's schedule it right now.
Yeah. Like, pencil it in. Thank you, girl.